Hi there, my name is Benjamin Uminsky. I'm a data scientist. I work for the Los Angeles County Registrar and Recorders Office. In my job, I have wonderful opportunities to work with all sorts of interesting data sets and business problems that require the use of data to solve them. One of those major problems that we face, and chances are if you're watching this Tech Time video, you're one of those election administrators that has the same problem that we do with recruiting enough and recruiting the right poll workers for election day. So as you can imagine, on election day, you're counting on a whole host of poll workers to show up and do what needs to be done so that the voter can come and vote with the way they want to vote. But unfortunately, that can't really happen or be done effectively if your poll workers don't show up on election day. And leading up to election day, chances are you're an agency that has experienced cancellations by poll workers, and you're left scrambling to find new poll workers and expand your reservist list to ensure that on election day, if you have any more cancellations or those no-shows, you'll be able to scramble new poll workers out, get election supplies out there. And at the end of the day, it could be a real problem and a headache for you as an election administrator. Well, LA County has used data science and the data that's available to us to attempt to solve this business problem of finding a way to predict who we should be calling for recruiting poll workers and who we should not be calling so that we can really minimize the costs of those poll workers that don't show up or are simply not committed. So for the next 10 minutes, I'm going to explain to you what LA County has done using data and data science to solve this very interesting problem. So some of you may be wondering when you clicked on this Tech Time video, what in the world is this guy talking about? And what has the EAC uncovered here with a prediction algorithm? What is LA County using a crystal ball? Well, no, of course we're not using a crystal ball. Those things don't exist. But we are attempting to predict for any future election which poll workers in our candidates of poll workers are likely, meaning they have a high probability of showing up on election day, and which ones have a low probability. And when we can parse out high probability versus low probability, then we can basically say, okay, for these poll workers in our list, let's call them because the machine learning algorithm has said they have a high probability. And for these others, don't bother calling them because chances are they're likely to result in a no-show or cancellation. So how do we actually achieve this? Well, I'm gonna explain a little briefly about the machine learning technology that we use. I won't get too deeply into this because it's only a 10-minute Tech Time video, but you should know that there's some really great sophisticated algorithms that are available free of cost. I use the R statistical program, which has no licensing fees, it's open source, to create this trained algorithm so that it can predict. And what it's essentially gonna predict for us is when I give it data, such as all the poll workers that are in our pool of candidates, it's gonna parse out who we should call and who we should not call. So you're probably wondering about the accuracy. So if it's not a crystal ball, how good is it? Well, let me stress, it doesn't pretend to be 100% accurate. I've yet to work with a machine learning algorithm that turns out to be 100% accurate. But it is really good when you compare it to not using the algorithm. So in our prediction model, we ended up using gradient boosting as the machine learning algorithm. Now, many of you that are probably watching this Tech Time video probably don't know what that means. At its core, gradient boosting is a decision tree machine learning algorithm. There's a lot of other things that it's doing, but to really understand what it's actually doing in terms of making a decision of whether this person is a likely candidate to show up on election day or that poll worker is not a likely candidate, takes all the data points and it goes through what are called branches and nodes to essentially make a decision at the end of the algorithm to say this person has a high probability and this person does not. So I'd like to show you this infographic that's very accessible, I think, to really anyone. You don't need to be a data scientist to really understand what's happening with the data and how the data travels through a decision tree to its final output of yes, will show up on election day, no, will not show up. But before I get to it, I'd really like to send real credit to the makers of this infographic. It's by the wonderful data science team of R2D3. Thank you again for allowing me to show this on your behalf. hopefully everyone will really enjoy it. So when you look at this infographic here, we're going to start at the top. And what you see here, what this infographic is really covering is data points in a different type of project. So these are not data points that correspond with the LA County prediction algorithm. It's an interesting project that was trying to identify which apartments or properties for sale were identified in New York versus San Francisco. And the whole idea is you could use real data points such as price per square feet, elevation, when it was sold, you name it, all sorts of different data points to really identify and classify which properties are sold in New York versus which properties are sold in San Francisco. Now, the whole idea is very similar to the poll worker project in that we're basically trying to classify a binary outcome, either negative outcome, meaning they didn't show up on election day, or a positive outcome for them, they did show up on election day. So using the same idea, imagine that we have all sorts of data points such as gender, such as voting history, such as work history for our poll workers, and it's going to travel down and have different points of decisions that need to be made. And at each of those points, it's going to fall into one category of yes will show up, no will not show up. And then at another branch further down the tree, maybe it'll change the outcomes of will show up or not show up until finally, and this is where you guys can see it, you guys start at the very top of the decision tree and you can see each little point traveling down through a decision tree, finally arriving to the very bottom. It's showing up as yes will be a poll worker or no will not be a committed poll worker. So this, I think, infographic really shows how that's actually working, where it's traveling down, you have data points on our poll workers that have a whole host of information such as, again, gender, median income, what their voting rate is in the last 10 years, and all of those points serve as some sort of decision tree node that's going to split the machine learning decision as to going one way, yes, we'll show up on election day, or go the other way, we'll not show up on election day. So now that you guys have seen a really nice data visualization and interactive infographic about how machine learning actually works, specifically decision tree machine learning, I hope you have a really good sense as to what kind of technology the Registrar Recorder LA County is using to really enact a great prediction algorithm to help us solve this problem of people no-showing on us, folks that are canceling on us. So to wrap up, to give you a real sense of how well our machine learning algorithm performed, let me give you a better idea as to what happened on election day for us for the June 7, 2016 primary. We ended up hiring 22,000 active poll workers, meaning on election day, 22,000 more or less showed up on election day and did what we expected them to do. They were committed. We recruited them. However, to get those 22,000 folks to show up, we ended up getting assignments for a little over 30,000. That means we had a ton of people that didn't actually show up or ended up canceling on us. So what do the numbers look like? Well, the worst of the worst for us was 4,000 no-shows on election day, which is really terrible because we're running about 4,600 precincts. So that comes out to a little less than one person per precinct did not show up for us, which is really terrible. In addition, we had a whole host of cancellations prior to election day, about 3,300. So that combined essentially led to a lot of work in recruiting and a lot of extra headaches on election day. And what does that mean operationally? For many of you election administrators, you know exactly what that translates. When someone doesn't show up, someone doesn't bring election supplies, you're sending out emergency supplies, you're sending out emergency workers that have to deal with this. So for us, it was, you can see that we are still dealing with problems. But the good news is that for some small portion that we operationalized our algorithm, we had tremendous success rate. So the success rates for us without the algorithm, we were looking at about 73% accuracy. With the algorithm, for those workers that we did identify and we did call, the accuracy rate was around 85%. And where our no-show rate for our general population of poll workers for the June 7th was close to 14%, the algorithm only got it wrong for no-shows about 3.5% of the time, which is real improvement for us. And this is an example of where we can really be making good use of this algorithm. So I hope today you learned a little bit about a very interesting and dynamic tool that the LA County Registrar Recorder is using. You have a clear idea and understanding as to why we're using this tool and how it can assist us and potentially any election administrator with limiting the number of no-shows and limiting the number of cancellations on election day that can really plague your operation. And hopefully you found it to be a very interesting talk. So tune in again for other interesting Tech Time Talks. Thank you for joining me.